Alright guys, welcome back. Today we're gonna be doing a league on Arena or on Modo with Scam. We're gonna give it a try. This hand, I don't think we're gonna keep this one. We got mana, but we have no red sources, we have no Scam start, so we're just gonna pitch it back. We do have to double grief this hand, so we will keep this one. And we're just going to put the Undying Evil to the bottom here. Right, so here we go. Putting these on Watery Grave. Good news for us. Cave Cliffs. Get rid of the Thoughtseize. Let's, where's the volume on this? Good lord. He's gonna focus subtlety. Not see that coming. I guess we put it on top. Pass turn. I guess we could have put it on bottom and hoped that he had a, I'm gonna try to find my volume control here real quick. There we go. We could have put that on bottom and hoped to find a red source for the Fury, but we'll just yield now. So this is mostly the same list that I've been playing. I played it in a few videos before on this channel. The one adjustment that I'm considering making here is that I might add the new card from Lord of the Rings, Cast Into Fire, from the into the sideboard. I think using that to be able to get rid of a One Ring or a Cauldron Complete would be a big boost to the deck. Cauldron Complete is one of our, bad things we don't want to see happen, so it's just a thought experiment I'm running with right now. I picked up a copy in paper, so I might throw that in the sideboard there. There's a lot of Hammer Time players in my LGS, so I'll probably give it a spin in paper first and then maybe commit to it online. And there's the One Ring, Speak of the Devil. Alright, we'll get draw terminate. That's not bad. We'll just lay the Fort Marsh Flats for now and pass. No point in swinging with the Spyro since I got protection. And draw some more cards. Yeah, a lot of people are talking right now saying the One Ring's gonna get banned. The One Ring's gonna get banned. And yeah, for the most part, I agree. The One Ring should get banned. That reminds me a lot of the Karn, Mikus, and Thladis lock after War of the Spark that led to Mikus and Thladis getting banned in Modern, to where it's kind of a colorless deal that you can just drop into any deck and be perfectly fine. And because of that, I think it should get banned. However, it is the poster card, the face card for their newest, for Wizards' most recent money-making scheme, with this Universes Beyond thing. And because of that, I don't think it will get banned. At least not right away. I don't think it's going to get caught in the August banning. I think if it gets banned at all, it's probably going to be at least a year from now before we see any kind of action taken on the One Ring. There's also the fact that Wizards doesn't really care about Modern or any other formats. They don't really care about the health of other formats except for Commander. Commander is their cash cow. The Commander's what they're focusing on right now, so I don't see them making too many adjustments for the sake of health of the format. grief gets countered. That's why we didn't run out the fury. We kind of figured blue with empty, with the open mana. Come on. Yeah, terminate. We traded off our Spyro for their Orcish Bowmaster and their Mass. Fine with us. Keep using the ring. Culligan's command. We are gonna fire this off. What do we want to do though? I think discard and return a creature. Get back our grief. And make them discard a card. Of course, I don't expect this to resolve. I fully expect it to get countered. The destroy artifact doesn't work on the one ring, unfortunately. But this does allow us to leave up the terminate if they play something we need to be concerned about. And here's the counterspell. Okay. I'm so confused. What the hell does this do? Look at the top four cards of your library, separate them into face down pile, face up pile. Okay. We'll let them see the Sunken Ruins and the Bowmasters. Make them think we put good stuff in the face down, so hopefully they'll take the two lands. They did take the two lands. And there's the counterspell that we kind of saw coming. And we missed the attack. I swear I'm not used to playing decks that attack. So much lantern time, I kind of just kind of skip through the attack phase most of the time. Four mana, new one ring. So what we'll probably do is at the end of their next turn, we'll probably just we'll kind of do the Season Pyromancer thing, get a couple more tokens. That's the other problem with One Ring, is you just draw into more One Rings, so you're never going to kill yourself with the One Ring. I don't think I've ever seen somebody kill themselves with the One Ring. And I've seen Saffron Olive playing the One Ring, so... Shoulder of the Apocalypse. Okay. On their end step, we'll activate... our Spyro here. Two more tokens. Yep. Alright, let's Thoughtseize and try to draw a counterspell. Or take one, maybe. And then terminate the Shieldred. Shieldred in One Ring is dangerous because they only lose life. Holy crap. So, Counterspell, Counterspell, Force Negation, Murktide, Murktide, Fatal Push. We're not getting anything through, are we? Yeah, we're not getting anything through ever. So, okay, Dimir, Murktide. That's interesting. Alright, what do we want here? They got plenty of. Blue. We got plenty of basics last game, so Mega's the Moon, I don't think. I don't think we have anything good in our sideboard here. I guess we can bring in the Unlicensed Hearts for some graveyard hate. Going down the fables because we saw the Bowmasters. Sudden edicts can come in. Go down to Spyro, and I think that'll do. Not huge on, don't think we have a whole lot for this matchup in our deck, unfortunately. Alright, well, we have the Undying spells, but nothing to do with them. So I think we could put this back. Dothy wouldn't have been bad. Keeping this. We're gonna put Bolt on the bottom. Gonna turn one Thoughtseize. And then Land of Fury next turn. Hopefully. What's this do? Draw three cards, Island Cycling. So we're gonna take their counter spell away. Will hopefully let us land Fury next turn. There's always a danger of them drawing Subtlety, danger of them drawing Force Negation. That's just Murktide life. So played Watery Grave. So you know about that. Draw a land, we didn't draw a land, so I guess we'll just go for the Fury here. Exile K Command. And get our Fury back. I'm sure they'll have something to answer it with. Okay. Now we just need to find a land. Need to find a land for this Delphi Voidwalker. Start keeping their graveyard empty, so they can't delve for this Murktide. There we go. Get a swamp. Drop the Delphi. Hopefully, he won't have a counterspell for it. Yeah, with the Fury. Be interesting to see if they drop a Bowmaster trying to chump block the Fury. Certainly looks like that's what they're gonna do here. Yep, there's a Bowmasters. So we know they have five cards in hand. We know about the Murktide and other Bowmasters and this revealed thing that cycles and gets them three cards if they want to spend 5 mana to draw three cards. Right, Sudden Edict. Yeah, let's Sudden Edict here. Just get this Bowmasters off the field without them being able to interact with it. I'll swing in. Really need to find red source plus, or well, a red source would be great. We need to find either lands for Fury or another Undying spell plus a red card and try to land another Fury. Comes another Bowmasters. Chump block and Fury again. Yep. Nice thing is, if they ever go for this Lorien Revealed or whatever it's called, we could pop the Voidwalker for Bowmasters and make them lose three. Not optimal at all, but if they ever go for a One Ring, we could do the same. Once they start drawing a lot of cards with One Ring, crack the Dothy Voidwalker and get an Orcish Bowmaster. Namo. There's still two unknown cards in hand. I was getting frisky with the Bowmaster. Interesting. That's why they're getting frisky with the Bowmaster. Damnation, okay. But well, now we're kind of up a creek. Yeah. We're pretty much up a creek here now. Dangers of keeping one lander. We never saw past land two. Now the opponent just kind of has carte blanche to do what they want. You're gonna draw three. I'm assuming next turn this Murktide's coming down. Undying Malice would have been really nice back when we had back before they dropped the Damnation. I'm not sure what our plan is here, honestly. I guess they could tap out mostly for a Murktide. And we could double Fury. And get it countered. I'm assuming that's what we're gonna see here. They're leaving up the two blue for a counter spell. But I mean, it's our one out, so we have to go for it here. No, we don't want to do that. We want to play this. Get rid of that. Blood Moon's no good because all the basics, which we probably could have gotten rid of that. It doesn't really matter at this point. There's a counter spell, and we'll scoop it up. That was round one. Gotta love those Lord of the Rings cards. I will forever hate that set. I don't think it should have been put into the competitive formats. I think they needed to keep the Universes Beyond stuff to commander only, kind of commander only legality. So put it into Legacy, that's fine. We keep it out of Modern, Historic, but that's probably generating them so much money on Arena. So you can't blame them for trying to get the money. It's just the game is more about the money than the players nowadays, it seems. But all right, well, stick around. We're gonna go to round two here in just a moment.